So, before I get into today's topic, if you saw my last video, you would know that if you are part of the hashtag notification squad, I said that I would be giving a shout out to one, if not a couple of people that were the first one to like my last video, and that goes to Wolfgang Linden Schmidt. Yes, that's right. He was one of the first people to like my last video, and so he's also part of the notification squad. So huge shout out and thank you to Wolfgang Linden Schmidt. Let's go ahead and keep this going, you guys. If you are one of the first people to like this video, then on my next video, I will be giving you a shout out in that next video, and you will be able to be featured on the channel, just like Wolfgang Linden Schmidt is. And also, we've actually been growing, you guys. We're currently at 692 subscribers, so we're finally growing again instead of decreasing down in subscribers. So let's keep this pace up. Be sure to smash the like button on this video, and be sure to hit that subscribe button. Be sure to hit that ding-dong notification bell. Be a notification bay, because Wolfgang Linden Schmidt is the notification bay for the day. So you guys, that has been it. Let's get going into today's video. Did you like that intro? I know you did. What's going on, y'all? It is your boy Avery here, bringing you guys a discussion video, something kind of going off the beaten path that I haven't seen anybody talk about yet, and that is asking the question, which monster zone is going to be the best monster zone? Now, this probably sounds a bit rhetorical or a bit of an oxymoron whenever you think about it, but when you get down to it, when it comes to link format, the main monster zones are going to matter. Where you summon your monsters is going to matter, especially if cards like Blasting Fuse become a thing where if the entire column is filled, then all cards in that column are destroyed. It's going to be very crucial in cases such as that, or even down the line, if more cards like Blasting Fuse come out, it's going to be very crucial as to where you put your monsters in the main monster zones, as well as the two link monster zones, aka the extra monster zone, whatever it is you want to call it. So, when you first start off a game, you're starting off with your five cards. Let's say that you're going first. 99.99% of players in this game, I would say, would summon a monster right here in the middle monster zone. I know I always do this, like when I'm playing Zodiac, or when I did play Zodiac, I would always summon like my Rapier or Teratop in the middle main monster zone. Because you would never really think about it. But now that we have to think about where we place our cards, where we place our monsters especially, we need to very much consider how we want to start off the game. Do we want to start off summoning a monster into the middle main monster zone, or do we want to start on the far left or the far right or something in between? And in my opinion, I think that the best monster zone, especially when you're just starting off the game, is going to be either the far left or the far right. I know it's something extra that you have to think about whenever you're making your plays, but it is very crucial in situations such as this because you want to be able to give yourself the best possible board setup. People are going to constantly be summoning their main monster zone or their monsters into the main monster zones here in the middle, but again, if something like Blasting Fuse or some card down the line in Code of the Duelist or whatever the case may be comes out that destroys a monster in like the middle main monster zone, people are really going to be considering putting cards in either the far left or the far right, or again, like one of these, something in between. So I think when you're first starting off a game, if you're able to put your monsters in the far left or the far right, it looks awkward, which can also kind of be awkward for the opponent because they kind of have to think about how they're going to approach you, I guess. Like they're really going to have to think about how they approach your board, especially if we get cards in the future, which it probably is guaranteed at this point, that deal with main monster zones. Like if you have a monster in this zone and they're connected to these two, then draw two cards or something of that nature. And keep in mind too that the link monsters point to specific zones. So let's say we get a link monster that says monsters that are linked to this link monster are unaffected by card effects. Well, if you already have, let's say, I don't know, a Vorce Raider and a Dark Magician here and here, and you have the link monster pointing here and here, the monsters that are here are unaffected by card effects, but what if you want something better? Like, what if you had one or two monsters over in these zones, and you would rather have it be unaffected by card effects in these zones? You're either A, going to have to play something like Senate Switch, or B, you're going to have to plan ahead as to where you're going to place the monsters in the main monster zones. Hopefully that makes sense. Or if we get more cards again, like Blast and Fuse, that say destroy all cards in this column, let's say they come out with a spell card that says if you have a Link monster in this card's column, destroy all cards in this card's column. Well, let's say you have a card here and here, then you don't want to be blowing up your own cards. You want to have them like here, here, or here, or whatever the case may be. And then once this card takes effect, it's obviously going to just, blow away your opponent instead of blowing away your own cards. It's something very interesting to think about, and I feel like that this is something that not a lot of players have really considered, since Link summoning is still very new and people are still trying to figure out combos with it and things of that nature. But let me know what you guys think. Do you guys think that playing your monsters in the main monster zones is going to have to be an extra thing that players think about when we get into Link format? Or you think it's just going to be as simple as, playing a monster here, sending them both to the graveyard, putting your Link monster here, and then maybe doing some more plays, putting a Link monster here? Let me know what you guys think, because this is something I haven't seen anyone really cover, and I would be interested to hear y'all's feedback. So let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Be sure to like this video. Be sure to spread it around with your mom, your cat, your dog, your grandma, whoever you want to spread it around to. We're finally growing again. Couple subscribers here and there, so all of the help is appreciated. Once again, be sure to hit that notification bell so that you guys will be notified every time that I upload, and you may be able to be featured on the channel if you're one of the first people to like this video. So thank you guys, and I will see you in the next video.